Welcome students, in today's session we will be studying about political science chapter 3 and the name of the chapter is why do we need a parliament. So let's begin the chapter, that is why do we need a parliament. What we will learn from this chapter? So we are going to learn from this chapter how parliament enables citizens of India to participate in decision making and controlling the government. Very important aspect, participation in decision making and controlling the government, in this people participation. Thus, it makes the most important symbol of Indian democracy and a key feature of Indian constitution. Now, my dear students, here see, India is a democratic country and in India democracy is there. Democracy means people's government, for the people, and which is by the people, run by the people and run for the people, that is the democracy. So democracy most important feature, that is people's participation in the government procedure, as well as this is the key feature of the Indian constitution. So how parliament enables citizens in participation in various acts like decision making, controlling government, we are going to see from this chapter. Now focus question, before start the concept, there is some of the questions. With the help of this we can make understand better what is the work of central government, and the second question, that is how is the parliament formed. First of all, we will see what is the work of central government. See, the central government performs some important functions. There is a state government in each states. In India, near about 29 states are there in India, and each states has its own government, such as Maharashtra government of Maharashtra state. Here, for example, the Punjab government of Punjab state, Gujarat government of Gujarat state, Maharashtra government for Maharashtra state, and so on. However, there are some tasks which are important for the entire country, such as foreign policy, defense of the country, etc. See, your central government which govern whole entire India, okay, and for the administrative purpose it divided into 29 states, and each states govern by its own government, own state government, okay, as we have seen here Punjab government of Punjab states. But some of the tasks which are very important, such as here mentioned foreign policy, means what type of the policy we should have, such as trading policy with the other countries, as well as warfare, sometimes warlike situation takes place, such as when disease outbreak. So that time the policies with the other countries, what type should be there, defense of the country, as well as banks, railways, etc. So that time to fulfill this task, for that reason the entire country follow some of the important aspects. So there are the central government do this task, which task, that not just in the hands of state government. Sometimes border issue between the two states occur, that time also central government interfere in the matter. Sometimes river water distribution problem occur between the states, that time also central government do this task. As well as sometimes judiciary purpose also central government interfere in the matters. So these work of central government done. Why should people decide? In democratic, the decision of the people matters in a democratic country. Democratic country, the people's decision matters. Okay, but why the people should decide? See, a democratic government is run by the consent, approval and the participation of the people or citizen. You see, a democratic government, that is working for the people. The people in democracy are the citizens and they are an integral part of any democracy. Any democracy's integral part, the people. They play very important role in electing as well as performing role. The people elect a few candidates who represent their collective voices in the parliament. The people elect their representative from each constituency, one representative elected to the parliament. So these people or that person elected candidate represent voice of the people, collective voice of the people means people's demand which arose by the candidate in the parliament. So that's why people should decide. Now, how is the parliament formed? How parliament is formed, we will see. For the formation of central government, the whole country is divided into 543 parts, and each part is called as a parliamentary constituencies. So whole entire country is divided into 543 different parts. Those parts are called as parliamentary constituencies. People in that area choose one representative, means from one part, one representative. In that manner, 543 parts, 543 representatives from those parliamentary constituencies. So here see, people in that area choose one representative who is called MP. All these MPs are the members of the Lok Sabha. Now see here, my dear students, 543 chosen representatives are called MPs, and these MPs, they are become the members of Lok Sabha. In Lok Sabha, the party which wins more than half of the seats in the elections make the government. In Lok Sabha, the party means various parties, they stand for the elections. So these members means more than half of the seats, the party which wins, they form the government. The remaining parties are called opposition parties. Lok Sabha is a part of the parliament. Here, parliament constituents three organs: Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha, and the president. Means how is parliament formed? Parliament formed by these three organs: Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha, and the president. These three are very important aspects in the parliament. The elected representatives of the public elect the Rajya Sabha MPs and the presidents. Now here see, parliament. The parliament of India is the supreme lawmaking body, is the highest and the supreme lawmaking body, that is the parliament. And it consists of two houses, the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha. Okay, you understood now? Parliament is the supreme lawmaking body as well as it consists two houses, Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha. You can see this is the parliament, and in the parliament which things are included, which are the organs of parliament? Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha and the presidents. How many members in Lok Sabha? 543 elected members. As we have studied that 543 parliamentary constituencies, from each parliamentary constituencies one representative elected by the people. Hence 543 constituencies means 543 elected members, and those members are called as MPs plus two nominated Anglo-Indian members which appointed by the presidents. Then in the parliament, which house is there? Rajya Sabha. Rajya Sabha, it is called as upper house, and Lok Sabha is called as lower house. Here Rajya Sabha, total maximum seats are 250. 250 Rajya Sabha members as well as a president. So parliament parliament which included Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha and the President. Now, what are the work of the parliament? See, Parliament of India consists of the President, Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha. And one more very important aspects of the parliament, to select the national government. Important function of the parliament, to select the national government. We will see how the Parliament of India perform the role in selecting the national government. First of all, parliament which select the government, that is the Lok Sabha. At present, the strength of the Lok Sabha members is 545, out of which 2 members are nominated from among the Anglo-Indian community by the president. The rest are elected, means 2 members are elected by the president and 543 members are elected by the people. The Lok Sabha has normal term of 5 years, but if may be dissolved by the presidents before the end of its term. Every Lok Sabha, its tenure or period is near about 5 years. But if the presidents wants to dissolve, that time the president has rights to dissolve the session before end of its term. Also, during an emergency, Lok Sabha dissolve. Lok Sabha elections are held at least once in a 5 years. The period in once in a 5 year Lok Sabha elections are held. 543 members, you can see, which are elected on the in the lower house Lok Sabha, 543 and 2 Anglo-Indian members elected by the presidents. Now, parliament existence. When parliament got existed? In 1947, the Indian parliament came into existence. That is the representative of the people. This parliament means what? The body of the representative of the people, and enjoy immense power, lot of power, because it has 2 houses, lower house, upper house, and these houses govern the entire country. To stand for the elections to the Lok Sabha, a person should not be less than 25 years of the age criteria for the Lok Sabha elections. Then the members, they should not less than their age should not less than 25 years of age, and the members of Rajya Sabha, means the upper house, person should not less than 30 years of age, and not a salaried government job, and not a government job holder person. The members of the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha are called the members of parliament, also called as MPs. So Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha members are called as MPs. These MPs form the parliament. So these MPs together, they form the parliament. Now the Rajya Sabha. At present, the Rajya Sabha has 245 members, 12 distinguished members nominated by the president, and 233 elected members. The Rajya Sabha is a permanent body. It is also called as the upper house of the parliament, as I said earlier. At Rajya Sabha, 1/3 of its members retire every 2 years. After an every 2 years, 1/3 of its member get retired, and each member has a term of 6 years. Its Lok Sabha member's term 5 years, and the Rajya Sabha member has a term of 6 years. The speaker presides over the Lok Sabha. Lok Sabha speaker presides the meeting, while the vice president presides over the Rajya Sabha. Here 245 members which are elected on the Rajya Sabha. Now, how bill becomes a law? An act or bill becomes a law. As we know that the parliament is the highest law making body a highest lawmaking body. A proposal for a new law, change in the old one, is called a bill. A proposal for a new law, change in the old one, is called a bill. And this bill to become an act, law, a bill has to be passed by both houses and signed by the president, then it becomes a law. See, any bill when become an act, that time it is passed by both the houses, means it agreed by the both the houses MPs, means Lok Sabha as well as Rajya Sabha. And after passing by both the houses, president, when president sign will be there, then only that bill becomes a law. So how bills becomes a law? Bill passed by both the houses, then after signing by the president, any bill becomes a law. Now there are kinds of bills. There are three kinds of bills: ordinary bill, money bill, and constitution amendment bills. These are the kinds of bills. Now coalition government. What is coalition government? We will see. When the party that wins the majority of seats in the Lok Sabha is invited by the president to form the government at the center. Any party, means many parties are there, such as now in the current BJP party is there, National Congress as well as JDU and so on. Like that way, these any party, if any party wins the majority of the seats in the Lok Sabha, that party form the government, means presidents invited to that party to form the government at the central level. If no party gets a clear majority, if many parties are there, so the votes distributed among the other parties and no any one party got clear majority, then what is happening? Two or more parties made together to form the government. That time what is happening? Two or more parties, they come together and they fulfill the exact number for the particular number for forming the government, and then they form the government. And this type of government is called as a coalition government. The parties other than the ruling parties institute the opposition, and the other parties which remain, those parties are called as opposition government. Such as in Maharashtra, we used to say Shiv Sena and NCP, Rashtravadi Congress Party. So this government is called as a coalition government, and the other parties such as BJP is the major ruling party which stood for the opposition. Okay, so here such a type of coalition government and the opposition government. Now second parliament important functions: to control, guide and inform the government. See, the parliament begins with a question hour. When the parliament session begins or starts with the questions, the question hour is an important mechanism through which MPs can elicit information about the working of the government. By the questions, MPs, they can elicit information about the how the government is working. By asking questions, the government is alerted to its shortcomings, which issues are there in front of the government, which problems becoming to solve, or which arises shortcomings, or which the remaining lackings, and as well as the the proposals, some of the proposals they are not up to date or they are not completed, even though we used to say like that the government which is making enabled, by asking the questions, the government is come to know about the development areas and others. The government also comes to know the opinion of the people through their representative in the parliaments. In all the matters dealing with finances, the parliament's approval is crucial for the government. So related to the finance matter, such as constructive work purpose, so financial matters which are very essential, so the parliament's approval is crucial for the government. So here parliament perform very important function, controlling and guiding and informing to the government. The third important function of the parliament, that is the lawmaking. So lawmaking is a significant function of the parliament. We will going to learn this is in next chapter. Now the people who are in the people in who which or who are the people in the parliament. So parliament now has more and more people from different backgrounds. There has also been an increase in political participation from the Dalit and backward classes. So who are the people in the parliament? MPs, those who are elected by the people from the category of Dalits as well as backward classes. Then we can see some seats are reserved in parliament for SC candidates, means scheduled caste, and STs, means scheduled tribes. Similarly, there is reservation of seats for women, and because of these reserved policies, the people participation from every corner or every category is, we can use to say, in the parliament. So hence the people, those who are in the parliament, we used to say from all categories, from all corners, Dalit, backward classes, women's, SCs, STs, etc. I hope you understood this chapter.